Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Shinu to my channel. Hi, I'm Akanksha. I don't know why I can't stop smiling. It's so weird. I think it's been over 2 weeks, not even 2 weeks, I think 3 weeks that I sat down and filmed a proper makeup look. I really, really, really want to. And I'm sorry if the lighting is off. It's 10:30 in the night and I'm filming right now because in the morning there's a lot of construction sound. But anyway, hi guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys? And today we are going to review the Beauty Glaze palette. Beauty Glaze palettes were the most requested palette for review, so I am gonna do that. But before doing that, there are a few people who didn't want me to do also, I think over 100-200, because of the asbestos issue. So I was not aware of this issue until, like, you know, some of you DM me that there is asbestos in Beauty Glaze palette. So apparently a few months back, there is a ingredient called asbestos found in the Beauty Glaze palette. So it is not the palette which I'm going to use right now, but there's a Gorgeous Me palette of Beauty Glaze where asbestos was found. So basically, I think this happened in the States. So states that Amazon took down the palette because they found that, and like there was a whole something going on, and then the Beauty Glaze resubmitted a lab report where they found it and tested that, you know, there is no asbestos in it. So Amazon put it back. So I'm assuming that Amazon did its homework and, you know, checked, and then that's how it restocked. And there's some notice on Beauty Glaze palette, on Beauty Glaze website also, that you know, all the products are tested, like all the ingredients will be tested from now on, safe to use, Gorgeous Me is back in stock, etc., etc. So I'm going to review this palette. I'm going to tell you how the palette actually performs, but buying it or not buying it would be your call, like if you would trust the brand or not. And basically, yeah, what does asbestos and what is the big deal around it is that asbestos, so all this is just my research, okay? I might not know a few things, but because you guys are concerned, I did read a few articles, watch a few videos. So asbestos apparently can lead to cancer, but a lot of people said that, few people just hype things up for no reason, but it is, of course, like, it's a serious thing. But apparently if you inhale asbestos, there is a tendency you might get cancer, which is, like, obviously really, really scary. But Beauty Glaze did submit a report which tests and shows that they don't have asbestos in it. So yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, if you want to trust the brand and go ahead, then do it. If you don't think you would not, then that's up to you. I mean, it's completely, of course, how you feel about the brand. I'm just gonna test and try the palette now. Gorgeous Me palette is the one which had that, and no other palette has been tested which has asbestos. And maybe, you know, that just like a few bunch of things I had or something like that, but I'm not going to use that. So I'm using the Colorboard palette from Beauty Glaze. So these are like just four Colorboard palettes. So there's purple, there's blue, there's orange and green. So I actually dipped in only just few shades into this and I didn't like try a lot of it. But a little spoiler alert, I did try the glitters and I was not like extremely impressive, but I just tried randomly. I didn't like try it like with a proper look. So yeah, let's do a beautiful look. If you don't want to see the look, then of course you can skip till the end and watch my final thoughts or what I think about the palette. But if you want to see how I do a look or a tutorial of some look, then keep on watching. And yeah guys, thank you so much for 30,000 subscribers. I imagine I didn't do a video after I hit 30,000. I really wanted to say, and of course there's a video coming up. I'll put a video after this or like alt after to up. I'll do a video after this for like an updated, like just like to know what I generally about me. So yeah, that's gonna be up maybe like next video, like sorry, next to next video or something like that. It'll be up. But first, let's go in with brows. For brows, I'm using the Precisely My Brow pencil, and I'm just gonna do my brows. You know, actually what, I'll just do my brows. I'll add the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer because that's what I use most of the time. And I'll be back for like the main eyeshadow look. So I want to make sure I use every color in each of the palette board. So like every color, every eyeshadow in each of the palette board, like, you know what? I feel like I'm new to YouTube again. I cannot talk, bro. Maybe I'll start with purple. By the way, I got this palette from a page called D Beauty Lounge India on Instagram page. I think I got this. No, sorry. I didn't get it. She actually sent me this palette. This is, I think, for around 2000 bucks. I actually wanted to buy, but then she was sweet enough to send me on her own. And the funny thing was, so I put a story that, you know, she sent me this palette and then somebody, like, people DM'd her that, oh, do you give a palette out for free? I'm like, guys, use common sense. I mean, if she sends me, she's gonna, you know, people are gonna see and go buy. Like, why would she send out random people? Okay, anyway, so I didn't mean to flex like that, but yeah, I mean, you know, whatever. So just let's take a minute to talk about the practicality of the palette. I don't know if you can open these up and use them separately, but I don't like this scrolling thing. Like, you know, they're so flimsy, they keep falling off, and I don't like that. Like, I mean, like, I don't know, it's just not like a good quality. They don't open up or stay in a page. They're like, you know, randomly moving everywhere, which I don't like. And sometimes I just want to use something, my hand gets over something like that, and it happens. So if the shadow is good, then I think everything is worth it. So I'm gonna just shut up and move on to that. I'm just going to go in with this palette purple and add that on the outer corner. Purple, that pigmentation for purple is good. I'm just going to pack that on the outer edge. There is fallout on the palette, by the way. So far, so good. There's a slight bit of fallout on my face. That's like normal, kind of. It's not like too much. And I'm just going to blend the edges even more. I hate when eyeshadow is very chalky and doesn't blend. So let's see if this blends out smoothly. I'm actually going to take a little bit of pink and try to blend this. So I'm going to go in with the... Or else, I just want to use some other shade, right? So let's go in with this, like, this peachy type of pink. It's kind of like pink, but it's a little more peachier. So anyway, these are quite pigmented, bro. I didn't expect this. I mean, that's a beautiful combination. I'm not mad at it. I'm proud of myself. Proud, proud, proud. I mean, there's no complaint about the pigmentation, of course, and they're quite blending well till now. So I really I told you, I think the glitters which I tried weren't that great, but the matte shades are performing quite well. It is taking a little bit of time to blend them perfectly, but again, for the price point, if I have to blend them a little, I don't mind. Okay, not bad. I'm just going to go in with this lighter shade. This is like on the green color. So I'm just going to blend the edges and soften them out. I'm going to go in back with the purple again, the first one, and I'm going to just deepen that up. Like I always tell, it's all about building and blending. Just going to pull the purple out a little bit. So next I'm going to do a little adventure. I hope this works out. So next I'm going to go in with this shade, this dark green right here. I'm going to pop that in the inner portion. You see how that looks. I mean, it looks fine. Next I'm just going to take a tinier brush and blend these edges out. Next, I'm going to go in with a lighter green. I wish there was a very proper neon green, a little light neon green. We don't have that. We do have like greens, but nothing like neon green, which would look really cool. Anyway, so I'm just taking this shade, like maybe I'll mix these two and then try to blend the edges. Maybe that was a mistake. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to again take the lighter shade and I'm going to blend and soften that, tapping off the excess and trying to soften that edge and blending it into that peachy type of thing which we just added. This alignment is very complicated, guys. I don't like it. Maybe we can remove it. I just haven't found a way to. should have watched maybe some videos. I actually never watched like any Beauty Glitz review till date. I think really, like never a review. Next, I'm just going to just cut my crease. So I'm going in back with the purple and blending those edges out so that we just have like a more blended out effect between the lip and the outer edge. Now for the crease, I do want to glow in with the glitter, but I'm very, very concerned given that I didn't have a good experience the first time. So I have two things in mind. I want to go one glitter like a liner, and the thing is, you know, these glitters have like something very sticky, so they're basically like, you know, a glue and sticky. So like, if you know, this is my hand and if I press it on my hand, they like don't transfer that well, they're like very patchy, and there's a lot of things left on my hand, like unless I like rub it properly. So that's where the glitters are. So for the glitter, what I'm thinking to do is I'll go in with this on the lid, and like maybe I'll add the this white glitter, like white silver glitter, like a liner, maybe like a gradient effect. I'm gonna try and do that. Like I told you, they are not like, they don't completely cover the lid, so you know, I'm just gonna try and make this work. Maybe I should like add a, you know, color or base color before that, so that the glitter is not seen so well. But you know, I just wanna try this for you guys, so you know. So first, I'm gonna try on the left eye, and then it's not bad. No guys, I just can never like glitter. I don't know, I love shimmers, I like metallics, but glitter, I don't know, it just doesn't give that very beautiful finish which I like. It's just like my choice. I don't know, I never like glitter like so much. I mean, there are a few glitters I really like, but this one is not giving me the vibe. Let's see like how the end look looks, but I think I it's just like in my head that I don't like glitters. So yeah, I'm just going to go in with a tinier brush, and I'm going to take this and try to make a line. I'm not sure how this would work with a brush. Oh damn, that's so pretty. Like it has green reflexes. I don't know if you can see this, but I can see it like in real life. So that's just not like white, like, you know, white silver or gray silver, which I thought. It has like a green hint to it, so when I apply it, it looks like green, which is very pretty actually, because I have the green, you know, here on the right side. I'm going to try and apply it with a brush and see how it works. So I'm going to take like this like flat brush. This is the BH Cosmetics brush in the shade number 9. So I'm just going to pack it and see how it looks. I just hope it doesn't fall on my face all over. I might have to take the word back that I don't like glitter so much. I mean, it looks really pretty. So I think the brush actually worked really nice as well, like the finger. So for somebody who has long nails, you can definitely use a brush, which is always a plus. And I usually like even metallics or shimmers, I always go in with my hand. It's a habit. I like how it looks. I feel it gives a lot of payoff. But compared to this, like this also looks really nice. It's same, like I think with the brush, it's even more better because you get that precision. So I'm just going in and back, adding that greeny silver. Just going to take the tiniest amount of purple and try to blend the edges a little bit. So the glitter I used the other day randomly was this glitter, and which I didn't like, but the other glitter which I use now looks really pretty. So I'm just going to take this blue, and I'm going to line my lower lash line with it, and then I'm going in with this blue and I'm going to blend that out. The blue maybe wasn't a very great decision. So maybe I'll just use a little bit of this pink and add it there. And yeah, I think that's about it. I'll just finish the complete look and I'll be back to give my final thoughts. Yeah guys, that is the completed look. Now coming to my final thoughts about the palette. Is it the best palette I've ever used? No. Is it the worst? No. Just like my eyeshadow. Is it the best look I've ever done? No. Is it the worst look I've ever done? No. So one thing I want to show is the shimmers in this aren't that great. I mean, I would not like this on my lid as much. I mean, the glitters are fine, but only the shimmers don't work that beautifully. Like a metallic shimmer would work like really, like pop really well, right? Wait, let me just swatch a nice metallic for you so you can understand. So I'm just going to swatch this Nikhar K palette. So because it's an affordable palette, but these shimmers are really nice. So I'm just gonna, you know, take this shimmer and swatch it beside this. So you know, that's what I'm saying, it like the shimmers are very faded out in the Beauty Glaze palette, and these shimmers are quite nice even if though they're like, you know, very affordable. So that's something you have to keep in mind. Like if matte shades are something you're really really going for, then you can definitely buy this palette. But if you want that shimmer and the metallic shades, you won't get it. And of course glitters are beautiful, you can check on my eye. The orange one which I used was like okay, maybe it was just because I didn't have any base or anything, so it didn't work that time. But now when I did it like completely, the glitter look beautiful. So I think if you're on a budget and if you really want a palette which has a lot of colors, you can definitely invest in one. Of course the mattes were really really beautiful, like they were really pigmented, but it did take a minute to blend it like seamlessly. And if you have that time and you're just doing it for fun, then that would not be a problem. I mean, if you have the money to invest more, then of course like you can invest in a better palette. But if you're on a budget and you really want something, it does the job. Maybe it just takes like 10 seconds more to blend than a usual like a very nice eyeshadow palette. So coming to the pros and cons, it is really really affordable, it has so many colors and it has beautiful mattes. And the con is again the shimmers. I think I'm repeating the same points again and again. So the shimmers are not that great, it took a little while to blend it and get it very seamlessly, and I don't like the packaging at all. I hope, like I just wish there was some other pattern. It's just too flimsy, dude. Like it's not something it's very like ideal. I mean, if you open it and put it on a table as well maybe, but if you want to like multiply use these things, like I don't know how practical it is. Maybe I'll try to figure open these up and then just store it and like kind of remove it and use it. And yeah, again, finally, it's all on you. If you can trust Beauty Glazed that, you know, they've tested and their products are safe now, definitely go ahead and purchase if this is something like a good matte palette, colorful matte palette you're looking for. But if you like, you know, don't trust, that's upon you, completely fine. But because, you know, so many, literally, I think, you know, if I didn't do this review, people would kill me. Not so much, I'm not that famous also. But anyway, so yeah, that's about it for the video. Thank you so so much for 30,000 subscribers, and I'll again try to be very consistent on YouTube every Tuesday and every Friday. So yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and yeah, please like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.